So should prostitution be legalized?
Oh.
Yeah. But that's not an endorsement. The idea that prostitution is some kind of valid occupation is the literal victory of neoliberalism that assigns every behavior a monetized value. It's the strongest possible endorsement of capitalism. When you hear this argument on when you hear it on the right, it makes sense. No leftist will argue in favor of legal prostitution, and like that it should be like a service that's offered and taxed and regulated. That's not left wing, okay? Nobody on the left would ever argue for that. And if you hear that argument, you know that it's really coming from capitalists, right? That person would have to be a capitalist. There's no. It the you know and like this goes right back, right? I mean, I'm going to say some things and I may upset some people, but I mean, what I'm saying is, it's written in Marx, it's written in Proudhon. Like it's at the crux, the core, the very basic of the left-wing position of things, okay? If you want to take a capitalist position on prostitution, go ahead. And the capitalist position on prostitution is that it should be unregulated. Do that, but understand what you're doing, okay? Don't pretend that you're taking some left-wing position because you're really not. So, I do oppose prostitution laws, but I also oppose prostitution. Okay, I don't think you should put prostitutes in jail. Okay, I don't think you should fine them. This is not the way you deal with this problem. But it is a problem. Okay, it's not something that we should just turn our heads to, but we shouldn't put them in jail. Okay. I don't oppose prostitution laws because I think the exchange of sex is a valid market interaction. I am not a capitalist. I oppose prostitution laws because they are ineffective in abolishing prostitution. You want to talk about, creating goods and exchanging them, that's one thing. You want to talk about selling, sexuality, that's not. You can't have this discussion outside of the context of a society where everything is reduced to having a price. Like I say, it is the most extreme type of capitalism that talks about prostitution as, an acceptable thing to exchange on a market. Most people that are not capitalists see the situation very differently. They have a hard time understanding the idea that somebody would go out of their way to sell their body to strangers for pleasure. That doesn't. I mean, that would be a very intriguing type of masochism, one would think, right? And so taking a more realistic position about prostitution, which is that it's a negative consequence of a market society, we need to look at ways that we can solve the problem of prostitution. And what are the effective solutions to this? Well, you need to get to the root causes, which are largely related to the enforcement of wage slavery. We live in a society where most people have no choice but to sell some abstraction of their labor in order to survive. Prostitutes are people that sell sex in order to survive. Largely, mostly. Okay? Just like, people that work in a fast food restaurant are there not because they want to be there, but because they have to be there because they have rent to pay. They have to pay the capitalists. They have to pay the rentier class. They are forced by the market to do things against their will. That is the reality of prostitution for most people. Okay, so this isn't a moral issue, and you'll notice that I didn't say anything at all about the morality of it. Okay, this is an issue of markets, and this is an issue of coercion, and this is an issue of free choice. And you can't talk about women making, or men, making free decisions in the context of a market society. Okay, there's no such thing as a free choice in a market society, because you constantly have all of these coercive forces that are, you know, making you make choices against your will in order to appease the rentier class. That said, I mean, what's the difference, right? You want to work on the corner, you want to work at the McDonald's, what's the difference? So I would consider it oppressive to restrict an individual's choice in who exactly it is that they wish to whore themselves out to, but that's not an acceptance of prostitution. That's an indictment of wage labor. So we often hear this idea that prostitution is the same as every other job. It should be respected the same way as any other job, but the anarchist perspective flips that around. All wage labor is prostitution and should be equally marginalized. So no, being a prostitute isn't different than working fast food, but that comparison doesn't put prostitution in a more favorable light. It puts a fast food worker in a more negative light. If we want a really free society, we have to give everybody the opportunity to make choices isolated from the social coercion of market forces. We have to remove the slavery of a market economy before we can talk about whether people are really making real choices. There's no agency in a market economy. Okay, that's nonsense. Before we can talk about agency and choice, we have to give people the opportunity to make those choices. And so how do we do that? Well, we can have universal, we need universal access to education. Okay, that's a prerequisite. Before we can talk about whether prostitution is a free choice and whether the people are doing it or not, we have to have universal access to education systems first. We have to have guaranteed annual incomes first. We have to have livable social welfare for marginalized groups like single mothers first. And we have to have a federally mandated living wage first. Once we get all of those things in place, then we can talk about whether prostitution is a choice or not. Until those things exist, we can't. Just like we can't talk about whether, you know, working at the McDonald's is a choice. And if you go and talk to the people that work at the McDonald's, most of them will tell you that it's not really a choice. Okay? Those things will not abolish prostitution outright, but they will restrict it to those that really choose it out of the enjoyment of sex. And then, I mean, who's to judge, right? It's your choice to be a slut or not. And if you're really into it, nobody has the right to tell you not to. Okay? But that's not what the law and the society should be focusing on. Okay? People are going to do what they want anyways. What the society needs to focus on are people that are doing or are engaging in sex work because of the economic climate is forcing them to. And the perspective on the real left is not, you know, how do we abolish the, you know, get the state out of people's lives. You know, that's not what the real left is interested in here. What the real left is interested in is abolishing the coercive economic forces that coerce women into doing things that they don't really want to. And if you talk to them, they'll say, well, you know, if you take this away from me, then I won't be able to pay my rent, or I won't be able to see my kids, or some other thing like that, right? And that may be true, okay? But that's no justification for prostitution. That's an indictment of capitalism. So people need to be very careful. Okay, this is one of those issues where a lot of capitalists masquerade on the left, and a lot of people that call themselves leftists really aren't, and you get this sort of confusion here, right? Okay, what I'm telling you here is, you know, and these comparisons, they go back centuries, right at the core of the left. And this is what I'm saying to you here is what the left actually believes. If you have some other perspective, you might want to think about reconsidering how it is that you label yourself. You're probably a market liberal, right? A liberal capitalist. That's what I find most people's perspective of this on. And when I say that this is the strongest possible endorsement of capitalism, when you talk to a lot of people that pretend they're on the left, okay, that's what ends up coming out on this particular issue, is that they really are very much in favor of a market economy where people monetize, you know, little bits and pieces. Another thing that in this category is the idea of paid housework. Paid housework makes no sense in any other system besides hyper-liberalism, right? Besides the most extreme type of capitalism. If we ever get to a point where we have paid housework, we'll be in the purest, most extreme form of capitalism that has ever existed. But somehow that ends up on the left, right? It's a lot of confusion, a lot of fuzzy thinking, a lot of cognitive dissonance. So yes, the left will oppose prostitution laws because this isn't an issue of criminality. This is an issue of economic inequality. And the solution is not to put, you know, victims of an unjust hierarchy in jail. It's to approach the hierarchy and to approach, you know, the inequalities that have created the problem in the first place, right? But don't confuse that with somebody that's in favor of, you know, trying to create a business model out of prostitution, okay? That opens up a whole new level of victimization. It solves nothing. It makes the problem worse. So I'm late again, always, right? I'm just heading down to get my hearing test. I think I'm going to actually be substantially late. this is a big part of the reason I have the disability, right? It's just that I can't, like, I'm going to get there and they're going to be like, alright, I'm going to check my ears or not. Get to work and I'm late, and they're like, you're late, and I'm like, want to send me home, right? I'd rather be at home anyways, right? And they say, you can't be here, right? And I was like, yeah. I'm gonna go camp out in the minister's front lawn for a little while. I don't care what you think. Okay, so yeah, this is just I get paid in the morning, so I'll need to do like this is actually like this is not the most rational way to do this, right? Because it means that I gotta wake up tomorrow morning at about the same time, and I gotta be able to, in fact, I'm probably gonna do a compost run in the morning. I think that's probably the best way to do this, right? If I do a compost run in the morning, and I'm overdue, then I can get the pills on the way back, go to all the stores I need to go to, I'm probably gonna get some coffee out of the, you know, all those things I need to do. So, but I mean, it's the, it would make sense to go grocery shopping today, but I mean, it doesn't because there's just, I get paid tomorrow, right? So, this would be better if it was tomorrow, but then on the other hand, I need to do the compost run anyways, right? So, that works out. Yeah, cats stalking me. Yeah, I'm with you. Anyways, I expect my hearing to be okay. I'll be rather surprised if I'm told that my hearing is damaged. I suspect this is going to be one of those, like, questionnaires kind of thing. Like, you go in for a hearing test, and that's going to consist of filling out a form, right? Like, can you hear this? And then you have to, like, subjectively, you know, and then, like, there's no objective way to determine if you can hear or not, right? So, truth is, I'm kind of expecting this. What is this actually going to be? You damned cats. Yeah. What is this actually going to be? This is mostly going to be just a waste of time, I'm pretty sure, right? But, I'm waiting for the other doctor. I'm going to have to go tomorrow morning. That'll be part of the things that I do, is to
figure that out, but I don't really.
Another one.
I don't really think that this, I don't think she took my complaint seriously. So, I don't really think that, I mean, if your doctor's not taking you seriously, they're not gonna do anything about you, right? So, I mean, the point of this was to, what the hell is that? The dog on the front lawn? Is on a chain too. Why would you do that? If you want a dog, have a dog. Don't put a dog on a chain in front. You know. It's distressing. No, it really is. Anyways, I think I was saying something about how I need to wait for the other doctor because this one's not taking me seriously. I don't even know what I'm doing right now. Like, I'm just ranting about nothing, so I'm just going to close this down. I actually have to wait. I can't get around here. I have to wait for the results of the test, so I'll come back in on Monday. That's not such a big deal. I guess I'm gonna go home, get something to eat, and get back to listening. My ear still feels blocked, right? So I don't. She seemed to, when she checked the pressure on my eardrum, she seemed to write something down, indicating that. I don't know. I'll find out on Monday. I think they may have picked up a little bit of data there, and that's. Again, I guess I'll have to wait until, wait a few more days for the neurologist. Although I'm thinking, let me think here. Today's Wednesday. Yeah, I know, I'm gonna have to, okay. I may just wait until next week before I do the compost run and do it all then. Do a compost run on Tuesday, maybe? Yeah, kind of makes more sense. Alright. It's a chilly morning, I'm wearing a sweater. And the wind's coming in on me here. I'm gonna grab a coffee on the way down and enjoy the walk, but like I said, the fact that she seemed to write something down when she went after the eardrum that I believe is affected, I think she picked something up. We'll find out.
It seems like the air is finally off. I don't want to press my luck. And we need to have more time in the mirror, you and I. You, the universal you, and I, the singular me. This is a nice surprise, but see, there's no humidity outside today, right? So that might be a big part of it, right? If the humidity comes back up. But for the meantime, I've got the heat off. First time all year that I can turn the heat off, and that's actually very nice. Hopefully it deals a little bit with the dry skin conditions, and, okay, so I gotta get something to eat, and, then I can, get back to work. I have no excuse. In fact, I closed the ritual machine before I went out. Meaning that it won't come back on again until tonight, and I'll get into the schedule right. So I'll do the vlog for the 28th tonight, so that, you know, and render it, and then I'll upload it tomorrow night, right? And so I got the conveyor belt going now, right? It's just gotta go. For right now, like I say, eat, and then I can get some work done today, hopefully. Plan it. And I see no reason why I shouldn't. Although I've been saying that for the last several days, right? I think it'll work out. I think everything's good. FaceTime, we'll be doing more of that, promise. You don't have to stare at my computer any longer. Or at least not all the time, anyways. I got some CRA information in the mail this afternoon. I'm out of salami, so I decided, well, maybe I'll get some hot dogs, and then I didn't, because they didn't have any at the store. But on the way in, I picked up a CRA stuff out of the mailbox, and I dropped my memory, yeah, she'll call him back. And after some haggling on the phone, which is the reason I don't want to be doing this, how long are they out there for? Like an hour and a half of my day wasted yelling at people on the phone, sitting on hold. That's why I was just like, oh yeah, all right, just like the hell with it, you know, keep your fucking $50 a month. But I did it. I need that. It's called a notice of determination, right? Whether I get the refund or not, at the end of the day, I need to get the notice of determination one way or the other, right? So that I can have it, and so that, you know, once they finally pull their heads out of their asses regarding the loan, they can say, okay, this is how much we owe you, and maybe even give it to me in one chunk. Or, it might even just go through, right? There's still some possibility that this issue will resolve itself. And, in fact, what I learned eventually on the phone was that it seems to be leaning in that direction. The reason being this. My tax return was finished on the 23rd. And in order to get a refund for July, they would have had to get it, I think she said, by June 8th. So the fact that on the website it said there will be no payment issued on this date, that's actually correct. But it doesn't mean necessarily that I'm out of luck. Because they actually haven't determined what it's going to be yet. So they said that in order to get it for the August date, I should get something in July. Okay, so the way this might work out is like this. I may get two payments in August and no payments in July, which is annoying because it's July that I'm gonna, you know, I have no shows in August. I'm gonna have, you know, extra cash for August. But it may work out that way. And then I'll get two payments in September, or is it October? I think it's, what, 4 and 3, 7 and 3. No, it would be October. I make it two GST payments in October. The crux of the matter being that apparently I filed my, but I didn't file my taxes late. Right? But I don't think I did. Or did I? Maybe I did. Either way, it's just a consequence of the taxes being late means, or audited, maybe, whatever. I mean, the assessment coming in late means that I'm out of luck for July. I suppose it'll work itself out. Next year I should get my taxes in earlier, I guess, huh? So the fact that it's telling me that it's not paying me doesn't necessarily mean that I'm not getting paid. It just means that I'm not getting paid this month. If it works out that way, I guess I'm going to get like a $200 GST check in October. It'll be $120 in August, which will be, I should get some walking frogs. That'll work out. Anyways, I don't know, like I said, I don't know how this is going to work out, but, I should, hold out some hope. And it's reasonable, right? Like, this isn't hope as an abstract. This is reasonable. I should hold out some hope that, the benefits might still be coming through. We'll find out in a few days. Or a few weeks, as it may be. I think he said July 12th, but I mean, I'm not gonna call them. I'll probably call them, you know, near the end of July to figure it out. I couldn't handle the lack of salami, so I went and I bought $2 worth of salami. Yeah. I've got a few days left of spaghetti. Okay, so what's gonna happen is the spaghetti will turn over. And it'll be, I don't know, sometime around the 2nd or the 3rd that I'll switch to tomato sandwiches. And I've got two entire jars worth of mayonnaise. I didn't expect to be. I've got two entire jars worth of mayonnaise to get through. So it's going to be tomato sandwiches for probably most of the month. And that's fine. I mean, they'll switch over to normal meal again in August, I guess. Tomato sandwiches are going to be cheap, right? It's just going to be like cheese and hot sauce and bay. Like, I could spend like $70 on groceries this month if it's just all tomato sandwiches, right? Well, actually, that's not true because I'll spend that on smoothies. But $130 is not unreasonable. Problem is, I'm not getting any protein, right? I mean, that's a big problem, right? So I'm gonna and because I'm trying to get my diet up, right? I may actually double, right? So instead of having one bagel, I may find myself having two bagels or something like that, right? Or eating twice, maybe not every day, but more often than that. That's a weird looking dog, man. The level of incest in dog breeding, it's it blows my mind when I think, like, every time you see one of those little fucked up looking dogs. That thing was a wolf, not too many years ago. That little fucked up dog you're looking at is directly descended from wolves. It's, remarkable to realize the power of artificial selection. You know, and then we look at ourselves and we somehow deny that, right? A wolf. No more than a few hundred years ago. A few thousand, anyways. The neighborhood has a nice smell. But, I gotta wait a few months, unfortunately. Being an absolute loner introvert has its drawbacks, the fact that I'm usually sober is a benefit to that. Like I say, the neighborhood smells great. Nice if I could just walk down to the store. So. What I really wanted to point out in this short walk here was not the salami; it was. The ears. I remembered on the way down
that had said something about the ear test being subjective, and they were probably going to ask me a survey. They didn't. It was... There were some obviously objective aspects to it, like sticking things into my ears and taking readings. That's what I want, right? There were some kind of middle-of-the-road types of things, like push a button when you hear a beep. I mean, that's better, right? It's better than a, write me your feelings on your hearing. Hey, don't laugh. A lot of the tests that we do nowadays are based on, you know, self evaluations, right? But it was better than I expected. That was the point that I wanted to make. I would expect that if there's anything obvious, then the test that they did was good enough to pick it out. So it wasn't a... Well, I mean, I don't know what else I could have done, right? Anyways, that's the point I wanted to make there. It wasn't an opinion survey. There was some actual measurement going on there. What could they have done? I guess if I had a better answer for that, I'd be doing the test, right? Yeah. I'm almost home. Just as an aside, I ran out of Caesar dressing a few days ago, and I've been using mushroom soup for the base of my spaghetti for the last couple of days. It's otherwise the same, you know, they got green peppers and tomatoes underneath, and, you know, the mushroom gives it more of a traditional Alfredo taste, right? And there's mushrooms in it too, right? Like little mushrooms in the soup, right? So, together it's, I prefer the tanginess of the Caesar dressing, right? But, and in the long run, the mushroom soup is actually a little bit more expensive. And on top of that, you can't, like, I wouldn't normally put quite that much on there, right? And you can't, like, use a half a can of soup, right? You gotta use a whole can, right? So, it's not ideal, but just because I didn't want to go to the store, and I was trying to save a little bit of money, too, although that turned out to be unnecessary. It is more of a traditional Alfredo, so this is, the end result is more of a traditional fettuccine Alfredo kind of taste, right? Alfredo mushroom soup, it's not that different, right? But, yeah, so that's what I've been doing, and, I got a few more days of that before I switch to the tomatoes. Again, no pants, must be careful. It's almost 6 o'clock, I think. 5:30. So again, a late day. Well, you thought I was doing. We got them up anyways, and I got the machine on. It's part of the reason this was a little slow to come, apprehension. Yeah. there's a lot of fear here, right? Troubleshooting this isn't a lot of fun. And, you know, I want it to work, but I'm afraid it's not going to. The air is off. Still, that's good. And I've had the heat mostly off. It's off in here, it's off in there. I think it's running very, very weakly in here. Yeah, just a little. It doesn't seem like it's on. Right, yeah, I don't think it's actually on. So, you know, this is all good. But unfortunately, my veins just blew on me again. What's changed? Tim Hortons. Coffee from Timmy's. Seriously? Well, there's that day I forgot to eat. I have something to do with it. I don't know. Let's get some work done here, and hope my veins don't blow on me in the process. It's an expected outcome, but at the same time, it's
A very disappointing one. I've done enough testing that I'm certain that the interference is magnetic. This is not a, I'm not dealing with a ground. Or at least the primary issue is not a ground. But look at the wire. How the hell am I going to maintain, you know, a strong twisted wire around there? It's a crazy idea, right? This is called a Faraday cage. The wire, the aluminum around the wire. But in order for this to work, there can't be any breaking point, right? As soon as the breaking point happens, the charge comes in, you know. And how do you do that? It's bent. It's long. I'm moving it around. So this isn't... this is nothing close to a solution, right? So what else can I do? Well, I can move. I could get the city to change the, or to go figure out what's up with the, figure out the source of the field and deal with it, kind of thing. And I'm going to have to explore that option, I'm sure. Whether it gets me, I don't think it's going to get me anywhere, but I have to try it, right? I could try, there's these little rings that you can put on the wire. But I mean, I don't want to introduce resistance to the wire. It's headphones. It's a terrible idea. So that's a bad idea. What's left? Well, I could line the, I could turn the entire room into a Faraday cage. But it's the same basic problem, right? Any holes in the aluminum, and then I'm spending all my time, you know, meticulously scanning the ceiling for holes in the aluminum, right? They make RMF shielding materials. I think that probably my biggest issue is the window, right? So I can get a curtain. I can get tape and put it over the curtain. I can get window tint. Second biggest problem is probably the doorway. So I can get, they make like door curtains. Alright, so I can put that in the hallway and we're in the space there. And I don't know where else. Maybe put some shit in the ceiling. Or something else maybe I could do is I can maybe kind of like build a tent on the space, right? For now, these are obviously all exotic solutions and all I got is the foil. And it's gonna break. And I'm going to have to be patient, I'm going to have to find it, and I'm going to have to fix it. Something else I can do to try to minimize the headaches is I can try to mix during periods where the interference is minimal, right? So, overnights, early mornings, weekdays, it's about 7 o'clock, 7:30. This is probably a bad time of night to mix, so you get the point, right? In fact, I'm considering going to bed just so that when I wake up, it's early in the morning, right? It's one of the things I'm going to have to do is I'm going to have to flip my schedule over, right? So that, like, I'm awake at midnight kind of thing, and awake all morning, and sleep in the afternoon. That's kind of my natural sleeping pattern. So I gotta transfer over to that, and once I get in it, kind of stick in it. That's probably the biggest thing I can do. But I still got the foil, and I'm gonna have to replace it. I'm gonna have to deal with it. I'm gonna get frustrated, and you know I'm gonna complain, but there's nothing else that I can do, right? Was it like this when I moved it? I don't even know. Could have been. I just didn't notice. But you can't unhear it, right? And you shouldn't unhear it. You want to hear it, right? Again, I can't mix with the other phones. They're shielded, which is good, but they're not flat. I need flat. So I mean, this is the situation. Right? What I should do in the short run actually is go ahead and listen to the new phones through the mixer. With the first demo, and just see what it's like, and I get back to the old phones when the peak hour has turned over. I knew this was the case. I just needed to remind myself of it, and I knew that that's the answer. I knew that I gotta go in peak, you know, off peak hours. I knew all this stuff. It's just, yeah. Now that I've got the full wire around, like I say, I should, in theory, have a little bit more space. But so long as there's holes in it, right? See, when I was listening to it, it was like, and it was fine. It was fine for, you know, long periods, and it sounded better than it did the other day, like the best sound yet, right? It's just that it's constantly breaking. Like every time you shift, every time you move your head, something breaks in the line, right? So it's gonna have to be the best. But I think anyway, let's do it overnight. In fact, I'm yawning, so I should probably just go to sleep right now. Yeah, I didn't listen to it all the way through, but the signal's clean, and it's clean, but it sucks. It's just, it's not flat, right? Pretty much everything that I expected was true, right? I'm not getting any interference from these phones. Because they're shielded, because they're newer. So that's one. Two, in order to get a decent sound out of it, you've got to crank the volume. Because that's what, you know, they have a lower impedance than, or is it higher? Well, whatever it is, the impedance is different. So it requires more volume. And once you get the more volume, like, it sounds pretty good, except the bottom end is exaggerated. Because that's what the kids want, is headphones that have distorted bass. And, you know, I was over this before, too. It's like, I like bassy phones, you know? If I'm listening to something, that's great. But I'm mixing with this, so these are not mixing phones. These are listening phones, right? But, you know, at the very least it was, I've confirmed what I wanted, and this is taking a lot longer, like everything else is taking longer than I wanted it to, but the point of what I'm doing right now is, you know, reorienting myself, making sure that things sound right, so that when I bring more gear in, I have controls, right? So, as expected, those phones through the mixer, They sound fine so long as you turn the volume up. At low volumes, they sound kind of muddled, right? At higher volumes, they sound better. And that's not like, I'm not like, you know, like cutting through this. No, it's the impotence. Except the bass is shit, right? By design. And it's fine, just not in this context. So, I'm gonna redo some wiring around the side of that and then get back. I can go to sleep. I'm too pissed off to go to sleep. I'm gonna give it a try after I rewire it, and if I'm not getting anything, I'm gonna have to go to sleep. Go cry myself to sleep. By the way, temperature update is great. I've got it. Well, like I say, it's like I don't need it. I think that a big part of it is turning the computer on. But like I say, I'm not getting a whoosh 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 whoosh. Right. So I don't know what that means. I don't, does it mean that he left for the day? Does it mean he moved it somewhere else? Does it mean the machine cut the signal in half? I don't know. I know that it's, 26 and a half in here, which is great. It's a little cool in here, but it wasn't really a hot day. So, when we get some hotter days, I guess we can let some more heat in. And it's, I think the heat's off in here too. Yeah, it's... It might be coming off and on, but it's 26 in here. 26 in here, 26 in here, and 25 and a half in here. This is reasonable. I can deal with this, right? You can tell that the air is running upstairs, right? But it's running at a reasonable level. Just a little bit of air, And you can't hear it. That's another thing, right? And I like the fact that I can't hear it. So I don't know what happened. I suspect he's probably gone for the week or something. I think they might be Americans. Because they do strange things, like they talk in Fahrenheit. Nobody up here talks in Fahrenheit. It really gives you away when you start talking in Fahrenheit. You're obviously an American. So might be going to celebrate his flag somewhere else. I don't know. But it's definitely better. And I'm still gonna want to flush some more humidity in, right? But for now, this is acceptable, right? So very happy about that. On second thought, why don't I skip ahead a little bit? Not a lot, just a little bit. What am I doing? I'm just going to go to the second demo and distribute over the internets in the places that I need to distribute it in. I'm not gonna close it yet, but I'll rebuild it in the way that I need to do so. And then hopefully by then, the peak time has come. I don't know when peak time comes down. I don't know, 9:30, 10 o'clock. I'll give it a shot after that. I spoke too soon. The air is rocking. Hopefully it doesn't pull too much heat out of here. We'll have to see how much of a difference that that computer really makes, huh? We'll find out. I suppose he was probably just gone for the day. Damn. Yeah, we'll find out. It's a little after 1 a.m. And did I get through it? I didn't. I have to say. But I got pretty close. And I fixed the headphones a dozen times or so. And it had noticeable effects every single time. I'd be listening, and then I'd notice a short, and I'd take it off, and then I'd say, okay, there's a hole in the wire, fix the wire, and then it's fine, and then there's a short, and see, this is unsustainable. I mean, look, I've got, So, I don't know. I know I've convinced myself that I understand what's happening, right? The air has been on all night. Like I say, I think that's the air. I'm not even sure that it even is air. I presume that's air. Whatever it is, it's been out all night, and I have a means of blocking it, right? So I know that if I can figure that out, it works. Another question, can I ground this? It's clear to me that it's not a ground issue, but I may be able to ground it nonetheless, right? So, meaning that, you know, the phones would pick up the charge, but it would, I'd drain it out of the other side. I don't know if, see, that strikes me as a bad idea, because I'm still fucking with the signal, right? I wanna block it, you know, one way or the other. So, this is terrible. This is a horribly painful approach. But until I can find a way to get some kind of EMF shielding, RMF shielding, there's no other approach that I have at my disposal. So I got up to see. I think if I was to sit here and adjust it more and fuck with it, you know, I can get through the night. I'm not. I don't really want to do that right now. I want to go to sleep. I've got to do some grocery shopping like first thing in the morning. When I come back, am I gonna finish the record? Probably. Yeah. But I'll be moving on. I will definitely be moving on to NRE001 for tomorrow. I've already got all the stuff posted. It'll be listening and analyzing. So this is done. I'm gonna stick with the gear sequence. For all I know, I'll wake up tomorrow and the interference will be muted, right? I don't know what the factors are on the fluctuation, right? I know that it's usually there, and the phone, and you know, the tinfoil usually. See, here's another thing to keep in mind, right? The interference might be really bad tonight, because there were some nights when, you know, a little bit of tinfoil was enough. Other nights where, there were nights where I was mixing where I just stopped for the night kind of thing, because it was just static, right? I know this is going to be long and painful, but life is long and painful, right?